Hello, Amethyst Lunatari here with another quick little update, sort of. Well, not really an update. What I was going to do for my 250th subscriber special is have a question and answer thing. I don't know if people have any questions they would like to ask. So I'm calling for questions here. Leave questions in the comments, or if you want your question to remain anonymous, leave me a message on YouTube instead. So that's that. If you have any questions at all, if not, I don't know. Maybe I'll do something else for a subscriber special. Maybe someone else has an idea for a subscriber special I could do. So I don't really have any ideas other than that at this time. The other thing I wanted to bring up, probably gets rid of one of the questions, but a few people have been asking where I'm going with the Skyrim Let's Play and the Elder Scrolls series in general. Now, going in order of how things will happen. What do you call it? The Skyrim Let's Play. No spoilers here, but I've finished quite a bit of the game, but I think there's a lot to go. I'm going to be hitting most of the major quests. Still not sure about the Dark Brotherhood quest. I'm definitely not doing. I don't think I'm going to be doing the Molag Bal quest. Not quests that are like. You have to be evil, like, okay, take this innocent person and sacrifice them, though, because my character's not evil. So, but I'm going to be doing most of the quests that seem to matter to my character and are not evil. And other than that, every place that I can explore in the game, all the dungeons, whatever, there's still a couple towns and/or cities that I haven't visited. So I'll be doing that. So yeah, basically everything except for those quests that don't fit. Basically the whole game I'll be doing. And after that, quest mods like Moonpath to Elsewhere. There's a game. There's a mod that sort of simulates, what would you call it? Amnesia: The Dark Descent, sort of. There's one that's kind of like in the vein of Castlevania. Is like a pirate ship kind of mod where you're on a pirate ship or something like that, or you're on an island. Yeah. So those are all very intriguing to me. I'm gonna be checking those out. So I'm not sure. I know I'm gonna be playing them either way, and probably with this character, I would think. Unless it requires for you to be a low level character or something like that. But even then, I could use an old save, right? So yeah, I plan on playing either, let's play Skyrim, just continuing on, or making it a separate series. Let's play Skyrim quest mods or something like that. So now I'm thinking about it. But as far as the Elder Scrolls Online, some people ask me if I'm going to be playing that or trying it out, doing the beta or whatever. No, unfortunately. As much as I'd love to. I hate the fact, actually, that they're doing a MMORPG because I'm afraid it'll take away. They'll devote too much time to that series, and we'll have to wait, instead of 5 years, maybe 7 or 8 years for the next for the Elder Scrolls 6. Sorry. Yeah. So, have a problem with MMORPGs. Whenever Quest came out, I was completely gone from life. It was quite a while ago. I played EverQuest when it first came out, so I was still with my parents at that time, though technically I could have been on my own. But I didn't have enough money to live. We lived in New York, so you pay through the nose for anything, apartment or house. But I'm digressing now. So yeah, I'm too addictive to get back into that. I have a family now and people depend on me, so I can't, you know, yeah, I'll end up getting kicked out or something eventually. So, yeah, I can't play one of those games without devoting massive amounts of time to it. So, I was this close to getting sucked into World of Warcraft too while it came out, so yeah, I gotta stay away from that. But as far as future Elder Scrolls game, I plan on starting with Arena, going to Daggerfall, and advancing into Morrowind and all the DLCs and Oblivion, all the DLCs. So that's, you know, that's gonna take years. So, but Arena, most of it is just, it's procedurally randomly generated things. Yeah, most of it is just, it's randomly generated quests. Fetch me this helmet and stuff like that, and you go and get it to you, and then they give you a little bit of money, and it's, you know, you could do a few of those, but after that, you know, it's like the Radiant quest system for Skyrim. You know, someone needs a mammoth snout and go get it, bring it, they give you some money. You know, did someone else need something else? It's just random. It's just the place and the item and the what NPC you're that gives you the quest. So yeah, from what I understand, the random dungeons that you come across, now I might be confusing Daggerfall and Arena a little bit, but in one or both of them, the dungeons are actually random. So I'm thinking for Arena, just do a few side quests. You're like, okay, this is the way the side quests go, and just go and grab the 8 parts of the Staff of Chaos, which is what that's about. And I'm familiar with the whole storyline from reading it in the Skyrim books, or the Elder Scrolls books rather, the books you find in game. So, yeah, I don't think that'll be that long of a let's play. Maybe a 2 or 3 months, maybe. So, yeah, I do want to explore like all the cities and, you know, because I think all the cities have their, you know, distinctive look to them, you know, and there's certain named NPCs. So, yeah, and then Daggerfall is a huge game. Daggerfall, they introduced, as far as I understand, they introduced the books to Daggerfall, where you had books you could read. So, whenever I play Daggerfall, I'll be doing a Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall. Of course, that's going to be over a year from now, most likely, because I have a bunch of games that I want to fit before I get to Arena, so a bunch of little, smaller games. My idea is to make, now Arena shouldn't be bad, but what I want to do to keep it a little interesting and bearable for myself is to have a long LP with smaller LPs sparsely throughout. So even if I'm playing Mass Effect, which I'd love to get into that also, playing the game, you know, Mass Effect 1, might take me like, I'm guessing here, like 3 months, and then Mass Effect 2. Even then, I know, okay, I've finished the game, because I feel more accomplished when I actually finish a game, because I really don't want to play, like, if I'm playing just two games, I don't want to play Planescape Torment in conjunction with Skyrim, because both of them are extremely long, unless I'm almost done with the Skyrim Let's Play. You know what I'm saying? I want to keep it interesting for myself, and I want to finish some games. So, yeah, these two are next: Legend of Grimrock and most probably Dungeon Master 2, I'm thinking. I want to get Mass Effect. So, getting off the track. What else was I going to say about the Elder Scrolls? Yeah, that's what I was thinking about. Eventually, and I might not do this until I'm done with the other Elder Scrolls games. I don't know. Maybe I'll do it sooner. What I plan on doing at some point is doing a another Skyrim LP. This one, of course, won't be blind, and it's going to be with a lot of mods added, with a lot of mods that change the world for a totally different experience. So, maybe the Assis mod or the Skyri mod, that just totally changes, you know, the way you play the game. I plan on having a whole bunch of followers, so the Ultimate Follower Overhaul, Ultimate Follower Overhaul, Monster Mod, which has been banned from the Nexus. I don't know if you can find it on Steam Workshop, but I have already downloaded it, mwahaha. So I have a Skyrim Monster Mod, Deadly Dragons, the Civil War mod, Wars in Skyrim, because Skyrim doesn't seem like it's in a war, it's just, you know, it's peaceful all over until you say, okay, let's storm right run, you know, so, and then, yeah, war, and then all of a sudden peaceful again, so there should be skirmishes throughout the countryside. Yeah, I'm thinking of playing some kind of throat noises, I love them. I'm planning on playing some kind of evil character. Yeah, completely evil. So, one that would be like, you know, Dark Brotherhood, hell yeah, just want to take over everything. And with your armada of followers. So, that kind of thing. And of course, I'll ramp the difficulty all the way up, because I'll have all these followers, at least 15 followers, you know, as I progress through the game and find them. So, most probably on master level or beyond master level, to where it's modded, to where it's harder than master level. So, hopefully I won't make a total ass out of myself and get killed every episode. And, that's it. That's all I had to say about that. So, yeah, if you guys are still listening, any questions, just send them here. If I get enough, I'll do a subscriber special. If not, I don't know. I'm not sure what else I would do. I don't want to take requests for games to play, because, not right now, because I have a lot of games lined up that I want to get to. Just too many games. Too little time. Even if I have 3 running consecutively, I'm not going to get anywhere caught up to where I'm like, okay, what game do I play next? You know, because I'm always way ahead. I'm months ahead. So I'll see my other, you know, update from December about all those games. Well, thanks for watching all this or listening to all this, and see you in the Let's Plays. All right. Take care.